This is the world's smallest hacking lab, and it's one of the most innovative projects you can tackle from your own home. I'm super excited about it. And today we are embarking on an adventure that's a little edgy, totally legal, we only do ethical hacking here, and incredibly empowering. We are building our own hacking lab, right here, right now. And not just on any platform, we are using this compact powerhouse, the ZimaBoard, a single board server, coupled with Proxmox, which is a type 1 hypervisor, to set up a virtual playground where we can unleash Kali Linux and WebSploit. So whether you are owning your cybersecurity skills, dabbling in ethical hacking, or just curious about the digital world's darker corners, this setup is your gateway. But why, you may ask? And you know what? Why not? What else are you doing? Seeing Netflix? Playing your PlayStation? And in a world where digital security is paramount, grasping the hacker's mindset and toolkit becomes your ultimate shield. And here is the kicker. We are using affordable hardware and free software, and all of that in less than $300. So whether you are a seasoned pro or a newbie, this project is tailor-made for you. So grab your coffee, tea, or whatever, and let's dive in. So first thing first, let's present the gear. So as the first thing is the ZimaBoard. Second is a USB flash drive. 8 GB is enough. Third thing is an SSD disk. Mine is 1 TB. Fourth is a Proxmox as our virtual environment. Fifth is Kali Linux, along with WebSploit tools for ethical hacking. And do you get it? Again, your own hacking lab in less than $300. Super ridiculous. So now look at the key components here in more detail. And the ZimaBoard 832 model features a powerful Intel Cell 1 processor, 1.1 GHz, with 4 cores, 8 GB of DDR4 RAM, onboard storage of 32 GB, and ample connectivity options, including gigabit Ethernet, USB ports, PCI expansion, and even a mini display port that supports a 4K 60Hz. Its energy efficiency, compact size, and affordability make it an ideal core for a cybersecurity lab, allowing for the running of multiple tool and virtual machine in a small desktop-friendly package. There are many videos about it in YouTube, so I will leave some of the best I saw as links in the description, along with the vendor's link, so you can check it out yourself. So we spoke about the ZimaBoard. Let's speak about Proxmox, the virtual environment. It's a comprehensive open source platform for virtualization based on a type 1 hypervisor. Unlike type 2 hypervisors, which run on conventional operating system, type 1 hypervisors like Proxmox virtual environment interact directly with the physical hardware, offering enhanced performance and efficiency. This direct interaction makes Type 1 hypervisor an ideal choice for enterprise level and professional use cases, including cybersecurity labs. So key benefits and features of Proxmox as a Type 1 hypervisor are direct hardware access. So Proxmox virtual environment runs directly, as I said, on the hardware, allowing for maximum performance and utilization of resources, which is crucial for running multiple resource-intensive virtual machines or container. Second is scalability and flexibility. So easily scale your virtual environment with Proxmox virtual VE, as we call, adding more VMs or containers as needed without significant overhead. And its flexibility supports various guest operating systems, making it suitable for diverse testing scenarios. The third benefit is high availability, and it offers features like clustering, automatic failover, and live migration, ensuring that your cybersecurity lab remains operational and accessible even in the event of hardware failure. It's not a must for us, but of course, it's great to have it. The fourth one is integrated web-based management. It simplifies the management of virtual resources, allowing you to focus on cybersecurity tasks rather than a complex virtualization infrastructure, setup and maintenance. Very easy to operate. I will show you along the way. And last but not least, WebSploit. So for the educational value in cybersecurity training, and WebSploit is an open source project designed for testing and automating web application attacks. It provides a framework for analyzing and exploiting web application vulnerabilities, making it a valuable tool for educational purposes in the field of cybersecurity. And also here I want to be clear on the benefits. So first is hands-on learning, and it offers a practical hands-on approach to understanding web vulnerabilities such as SQL injection and cross-site scripting and cross-site request forgery, CSRF, among many others. It also provides a wide range of modules. It comes equipped with a variety of modules that target different web vulnerabilities, providing a comprehensive toolkit for penetration testing and security training. Its ease of use, and despite its powerful capabilities, WebSploit has a user-friendly interface that makes it accessible to beginners while still offering depth for more advanced users. Last but not least, so integration with Kali Linux. And as part of the Kali Linux arsenal, WebSploit benefits from a seamless integration with other tools and a supportive community, enhancing its educational value. Choosing WebSploit for educational purposes enables students and enthusiasts to gain valuable real-world experience in identifying, analyzing, and exploiting web application vulnerabilities. So combined with the solid virtualization foundation provided by Proxmox VE on the ZimaBoard A32, you can have a powerful, accessible platform for diving deep into cybersecurity practical and theoretical aspects. So getting started with the ZimaBoard is extremely easy, I promise. So first of all, connect the ZimaBoard with your router or cable modem through the RJ45 cable. You have two ports for that. Plugging in the power cable and see the light indicator for network flash. Open a new tab in your browser and just type casaos.local. And that's it, guys. Super easy, and by default, game on. Now, if you ask what is casaos, it's the ZimaBoard operating system, which was developed firstly to run Dockers, and it's pretty cool. As one, it's based on Debian. So basically, instead of installing Ubuntu or installing Docker and the add-on, it can handle it all by itself, which is important. Second, it has its own interface, which provides an exceptional user experience. And it's very easy to load whatever program you need or install any more app you want. And as you can see, it's very easy to navigate. You have clear dashboard and has Apple feeling, at least in my point of view. Okay, so with that done, let's start to install Proxmox on the ZimaBoard, which is also pretty straightforward, but let me guide you. So step one, again, pretty easy, download Proxmox on your USB flash drive. So go to proxmox.com, choose download, and go to the virtual environment and click on the ISO images and choose the latest version. For me, it's 8.1, but I don't know when you are going to see this video. The version might be, of course, much more advanced. It doesn't matter. Super easy to find it. So while this is downloading, we are going to get a tool that actually writes this ISO to our flash drive. And I'm on Windows and I will demonstrate on it, but if you are on Mac or Linux, there are also great tools like Etcher, which is fantastic in my mind. But again, I'm on Windows, so we'll demonstrate using Rufus. There it is, and I will scroll down to the downloads. Click on that, download the executable, and launch it. So Rufus, here we go. And first thing first, our device. Make sure you select the USB drive and not anything else, and then select our image or our ISO that you just downloaded it. And that's pretty much it, and we are going to hit start. But, and this part is very important, don't forget to do this. Click on start when you get the message on the screen. So choose the mode DD, click OK, and it's doing it. That's it. I tried the other way, it didn't work, so DD is the right way. And it's done. Time to get my USB flash drive. So step two, install Proxmox on the ZimaBoard, and it's pretty fast and awesome, so I'm excited to do it. But remember, the goal is to boot from the USB flash drive. So the ZimaBoard will not automatically boot to this, so you might need to change the BIOS config for it. And I will show you this real quick. I will boot mine. Now for me, I need to press the delete key immediately to enter the BIOS. Now move to the boot tab, scroll down to boot options, and choose USB flash drive. Save and exit, and here you go. So now Proxmox will boot, and first option we have is install Proxmox VE, hit enter, and it's going to do stuff. Now take a break to read the EULA. Press agree. Choose your hard disk on where you want to install Proxmox, click next, and put some location information. Click another next, and then your password, and I think we are almost there. Go to click next one more time, and that's important. You will see host name, and click on next as well. Double check all of the params, make sure it's good, and when ready, click on install, and great, it's going about it. And it's going to be quick, and reboot by itself, so you can remove your USB now. And here it is. For the more exciting things, to install our penetration testing tools and vulnerable applications. And for that, my good friend Filipi Pires has given us a golden recommendation and pointed me for the tool that has been making waves for all the right reasons, the WebSploit Labs, created by Omar Santos. So shout outs to Omar, and check his YouTube channel, he's great, and definitely will be happy to host him here. So WebSploit is renewed for its robust capabilities in networking and web vulnerability scanning, making it an indispensable tool for ethical hackers in my mind. So let's get into it and see how WebSploit can elevate our ethical hacking game. And to start with, download Kali or PowerOS, I use Kali, and install any of these distributions in a virtual machine. Use the hypervisor of your choice. Again, I use Proxmox here, so please follow me, but you are free to use other hypervisors. What is important are the minimum virtual machine requirement, 8 gig of RAM, 2V CPUs, and 50 gigabyte of hard disk. So now that we download Kali Linux and install Proxmox, let's create our virtual machine. And to do so, open your Proxmox, right click on your PVE on the left, select create virtual machine. Following that, just proceed throughout the screen to assign the right resources for the VM, choose a name to the machine, select the right ISO we downloaded, set the hard disk to 50 gig minimum, set the CPU to 2 cores, and adjust the memory to 8 gig. Rest is next, 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 and that's it. Following it, your VM will boot and load up with the Kali installation. I chose here a graphical installation and follow the configuration steps, which are pretty easy. You know the language, the keyboard, location, etc., etc., etc. It takes some time, so be patient as well. So after you have installed Kali Linux, run the following command from a terminal window to set up your WebSploit environment. You can do the CURL with the URL of the WebSploit organization to run the script to install. And this command will install all the tools, dockers, the intentionally vulnerable containers, and numerous cybersecurity resources. By the way, to make sure you are using the latest version, you can use this command as the wget, again with the WebSploit organization, with an update of the shell script and sudo bash update shell script, because I don't know exactly which one you are using, just to be on the safe side. Some notes that you guys need to look after, which I learned that WebSploit Labs is not supported in Apple M1 M2 Max due to compatibility issues with hypervisors and Docker. If you know differently, please let me know, because I installed it on Windows. I didn't check on Mac, but that's what I learned. And also be aware that the Docker service is not configured at the boot time. This is to avoid for the vulnerable application to be exposed by default. So to start the Docker service, write in your Linux terminal service docker start, and to obtain the status of each Docker container, use the following command as sudo docker ps. By the way, as part of the WebSploit installation, it comes with a script called containers.sh. And if you execute this script, you actually have two sections. The section you see at the top allows you to see what are the vulnerable containers that come with the WebSploit and associated to the exposed port. In our case, we are looking at the juice shop, which is assigned to port 8882. And below is what is actually running on the system, and you can see that port 8882 is associated with port 3000 in the container. So now that we know, we have to connect into port 8882 to interact with the juice shop. I will open my browser to go to my 127.0.0.1. Then we'll write the port number, and I can see that the application called juice shop is now started. So basically, it's a fictitious shop selling juices, and you can interact with this application to find tons of different vulnerabilities. And one of the first things you have to find is a scoreboard in order to unlock around 400 exercises and enhance your skills. And this environment, the juice shop, is a capture the flag-like environment with exercises and competition, and through the scoreboard you can track your progress, but it's not a must, just if you feel competitive. That's what I'm doing all the time, need to relax as well. But again, you can do it by yourself. Now, to look for the scoreboard, either right-click and view the page source, or right-click and inspect specific elements. Use Ctrl F on score until you find the scoreboard menu, copy it in the HTML URL, and here we go. Now, you can see the difficulties by each exercise, where the complexity is ranked by star. The higher the number of stars, the more difficult the exercise will be. And as you can see, there are tons here. Now some highlights, and we can start with a couple of exercises that are fairly easy. They even give you the strings to look for vulnerabilities. What is highlighted is cross-site scripting, and there are different types of cross-site scripting. The reflected cross-site scripting is a non-persistent attack. In simplified manner, the attacker will check for input validation issues, where it allows him to inject a script, usually a JavaScript, to redirect user to specific malicious site or steal cookies or session ID, and then be able to do session hijacking or session certain type of attacks. It can also pop up window and interact with the user to retrieve sensitive information and do many other manipulations. The second thing is DOM. And a DOM-based cross-site scripting attack happens when a threat actor modifies the document object module, the DOM, environment in the victim's browser. So while the HTML itself doesn't change, the code on the client side executes differently. The idea behind it is to store something in the database or file. But due to the longevity of the video, let's stop here and continue in a second part. If you are interested to see more, please write me what you are looking for. If you are familiar with WebSploit and stuck with some exercises, also let me know. The goal was here to install the lab, to prepare all the software and the vulnerable application. And in the next video, I will start to do some of the exercises. If you have more ideas for this hacking lab, please let me know. So to conclude, if you survived until now, hopefully you were. So we have just scratched the surface of what's possible in our mini hacking lab using the ZimaBoard and Proxmox to dive into the realms of Kali Linux and WebSploit. But this journey into cybersecurity is far from over. So as I said before, next time we are upping the ante. We will tackle more complex challenges, test our skills against virtual fortresses, and dive deeper into the hacker's toolkit. It's not just about, again, learning, it's about doing, challenging, and innovating. So stay tuned, because we are just getting started, and together let's unlock the next level of our hacking lab. See you in the next video.